to life. It must be magic.
Magic? My hat magic?
Just look.
If that hat is magic, I want it back.
But it's not yours anymore. You threw it away.
Don't talk back to your elders, you naughty, naughty little girl. And you stay in there, or there'll be no carrots for Christmas.
But you can't take that hat back. It brought Frosty to life.
You saw it happen.
I saw nothing of the kind. Quiet. I can't lose that hat if it's really got magic now. It'll make me a billionaire magician.
But we saw Frosty come to life, didn't we?
Uh-huh. Oh, we sure did.
You silly children believe everything you see. When you're grown up, you'll realize that snowman can't come to life.
But we...
Silly, silly, silly.
Oh, Frosty, we don't care what grown-ups say. We know you did come to life.
We know, Frosty. We just know.
Frosty, the snowman, was a jolly happy soul. Till it caught a pipe in the puppy nose and two eyes made out of coal.
Frosty, the snowman, he's a fairy tale, they say. He was made of snow, but the children know how he came to life one day.
Special presentation of Frosty the Snowman is sponsored by Target. Expect more, pay less.
Now, of course, the hat meant a lot to Frosty and the children. That fight must be made very clear. Therefore, Hocus Pocus was entirely in the right in what he was about to do. Children just as fast as it could.
Look, the hat's back. Let's see if it'll make Frosty alive again.
I said my first words, but snowmen can't talk. All right, come on now, what's the joke? Could I really be alive? I mean, I can make words, I can move, I can juggle, I can sweep, I can count to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9, 6, 8. Well, I can count to 5. What do you know? I'm even ticklish. In fact, I'm all living. I am alive. What a neat thing to happen to a nice guy like me.
That must have been some magic. And that old soap hat they found. Oh, when they placed it on his head, he began to dance around.
Is there a thermometer around here?
Over there in the wall. Why?
Oh, I was afraid of that. The thermometer's getting red. I hate red thermometers.
Why, Frosty?
Because when the thermometer gets all reddish, the temperature goes up. And when the temperature goes up, I start to melt. And when I start to melt, I get all wishy-washy.
Then you've got to go someplace where you'll never melt.
The only place I'd never melt is the North Pole.
Then we've got to get you there.
Yeah, we'll take you downtown to the railroad station and put you on a train.
Great. I always wanted to see the town. Let's make a party out of it. Let's have a parade.
Traffic light.
What's a traffic light?
Up there on the lamppost.
What's a lamppost?
Oh, you want a ticket, wise guy?
I'd love one. To the North Pole, please.
Huh?
You've got to excuse him, sir. You see, he just came to life, and he doesn't know much about such things.
Oh, well, okay, if he just came to life. Oh, that's sick of snowman. Once they come to life, they don't know nothing.
Come to life?
Too.
What is it, Hocus? Out the window? A refrigerated boxcar. On a train headed north. You'll be safe there, Frosty. Come on. It's full of ice cream and frozen Christmas cakes.
What a neat way to travel.
Hurry up, Frosty. The train is pulling out.
Are you coming to the North Pole, too?
I'm sure my mother won't mind. As long as I'm home in time for supper.